I'm here for round one, and we've won the roll. This hand is pretty good, so I'll keep. With mono blue, you can't really do a lot of mulliganing. As is true with most decks based upon synergy rather than individual card power level, you need a lot of cards for your deck to operate well. Okay, Foundry Street as in. Mono red is a very, very good matchup for mono blue. And I actually like playing mono red a lot, but one of the reasons I don't think that's an option is because the mono blue matchup is just unwinnable. Tidebinder Mage is very strong, and so is. And Master of Waves is just unbeatable. Since I have two masters, I'm just going to stay back with my Cloudfin Raptor. There's no need to be aggressive. I'm just going to win the game as long as I get to cast all of my spells. Okay, Lightning Strike is pretty good. I don't really want to block with my Cloudfin Raptor, it's just two damage, and the Cloudfin Raptor will get bigger and generate a whole nother elemental with Master Waves. So, one trick with Cloudfin Raptor, if it happened to be a 0/1 instead of a 1/2, is to stack the triggers such that the evolve trigger is underneath the master trigger. That way, if the master, that way the Cloudfin Raptor evolves twice because the tokens come into play, and evolve the raptor, and then the master comes into play, evolving the raptor. If the master were to be killed in response, it would still evolve twice. Yep, and Mono Red just has no way to beat Master. So the plan against Mono Red is pretty simple. I want to live until I cast a Master of Waves, and another powerful card against them is Rapid Hybridization. It's very easy to kill your own one drop once they've attacked and eat a two toughness creature in combat. I'm going to board in Dispel to protect my creatures against Lightning Strike and cards similar like that. And Domestication just because it's better than Bident in this matchup.